Hi, everybody. Corinne Blackstone here, and I'm so excited to have you here today. Welcome to my computer. This is going to be a really fun and easy tutorial, but one that I think is super needed. Before we get started, be sure that you're subscribed here on YouTube. That way you don't miss out on any of the crafty content that I have coming. But we're going to talk about the difference between group and attach. This is a question I see all the time, and I hope that this video will help you understand the difference just a little bit more. That way you can be super successful with all of your Cricut projects. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, I know that attach and group can be really confusing for people, and I see a lot of people giving that wrong advice in a lot of the Facebook groups or like on comments and stuff under posts. So I want to explain the difference between attach and group to you today so that you know exactly what to do and you can help others learn what they mean as well. So we're going to start with an SVG. And I'm gonna upload this design. So I'm gonna click upload and I'm gonna upload my image. Now I did check these out to make sure that these would kind of help us so I could show you what each of these means. I will link them down below if you wanna use them. The first one I'm gonna put in is a cat related design, and you can see that this has two different colors. This is actually sliced out of the cat, so you have pink and black. Now it's an SVG, so all I have to do is click continue. It's gonna bring me to this screen to ask me to like change my image name, and I'm just gonna call it I Don't Bring Bad Luck. You can add any tags, you can put it into any of your collections here, and then you just click upload. Now it's gonna put it into our design space screen here so that we can take a look at it. Now I am gonna leave it pretty big here because we're not gonna actually cut this out, but it will help you see all of the different elements. Now, a lot of people go, well, how do I know if it's an image that I can ungroup? Because maybe I wanna change the color, maybe I wanna take some part out of it, you know, something like that. Very easily, when you look over into your layers panel over here, you'll see that your image has this little tiny triangle right there. That is gonna tell you that you have multiple layers in your design. Now, if you click on that little arrow, it'll bring all of your layers and show you what they all look like. Now, you're gonna notice that right now, when I have it like this, where it's all under that arrow, if I click anywhere on my design, it will move the whole entire design. And also, if I click off of it, click back on it, and resize it, everything's gonna resize the same. But let's say I wanna change some stuff, I wanna ungroup it, I wanna see how everything's put together, because I can see here that we have this section here is black and this section here is black, and to line them up would be pretty easy, but I wanna make sure maybe I wanna keep the two pink ones together so that I can line those up a little bit better so that I don't have to try to like press the cat, whatever it may be. So we're gonna ungroup our design. To ungroup your design, you are going to click right here where there's these two squares, and if you hover over it, it'll say ungroup. So we can ungroup it. Now what you're gonna see is that you have different pieces. So we have our cat, we have the word bring, the words I don't, your life was, and then the already word I won't say. Now we can move all of these around individually and change things like color. Like let's say maybe we want this to be blue and then we'll leave the bottom part pink. All right, cool, let's do that. So that's cool, I like that, sure. But now I wanna resize some things, and you'll notice that if I do that, I'm gonna end up having to resize other parts. So like especially down here where it's like already the little, we'll call that the cursive font since it's got a bad word. If I size that and then I wanna size this down, it's gonna be a little difficult to get it exactly where I need it to be. So I'm gonna undo that really quick. But what I can do if I wanna make sure I wanna resize it, I can make sure to grab both pieces, and I can then again use this group option. And then I can move these around the screen wherever I want them, and I can also size them easily. But if I wanna ungroup them, that's okay too. I can do that. Now I'm gonna click undo a bunch because I wanted this back to like where everything was laid out so that we can show you how to use the attach. I wanted to show you what happens when you ungroup. It just gives you all those different options. Now, when we go to make this, I'm gonna click make really quick so you can see. I'm not gonna save my project, that's fine. But if we don't do this attach step, you're going to have to line everything up. So you have the black cat and the cursive font, and then you have all the pieces of your pink that you're going to have to line up yourself. You're going to have to be really confident in getting everything centered. So if you don't want to do that, and that's totally okay if you don't, we're going to go back over to our design, and I want you to select only like colors. So I'm going to select the black cat, and I want to select the cursive font. Now I can do that either down here by holding shift on my keyboard, or I can also do it up here in the layers panel where I can grab that and then hold shift and grab the black cat. Then I'm going to use, apparently my black cat wanted to say hi. Then I'm going to go ahead and use attach. You want to make sure that you're only attaching like colors, and I'll show you what happens if I attach the entire design. If I click attach for the entire design, you'll see that everything becomes the same color. And that's one of the big problems that I see people have, is that when they attach, they're like, oh no, everything's all the same color. What have I done? And it's because it's telling Design Space that this is all going to hold together on the same sheet of your material. Now, if you don't want to do that and you made a mistake, that's okay. You can hit undo, or you can also detach, but I like to just hit undo. Now I want to attach all of our pink parts so that those are easy to line up, so I can go ahead and attach those. Now, when I click make, you're going to see that everything will be held in place. You can see here, it's going to tell me I need a Big Mac because I left this big, but that's okay. You can see here that my cat and the cursive font is held together. And then over here, we have the I don't bring and your life was all held together. Now, yes, does this waste a little bit of vinyl? It does. But if you're not confident in lining things up, this is a way to do it that's really easy. So like I said, this is what, that's what attach is for. Group is if you want to hold it all together on your mat. So you can absolutely group them after you attach them if you want to size them and you don't want to have to worry about grabbing everything. So group holds together on your canvas, and attach is for like colors when you click make. Now I'm going to show you another example that has a lot more layers in it, and we'll play with that one. So I'm just going to move him over and hide him, and I'm going to upload our next design by clicking upload, upload image, and I'm going to drag and drop that image. Now I've definitely done this design before, and I know that this one's really messy. So I'm going to show you this. I'm going to click continue, and I'm going to click upload. And then it's, first off, it's going to be huge when it uploads. So I am going to make it smaller so that you guys can see it. And I'm going to bring it up. Now it is adorable. So stinking cute. But you can see here that it does say group and that it has the arrow. So I'm going to click that arrow. Now this one here has multiple groups in it, and that can be a little daunting. Now, like I said, it's currently grouped so that everything is held together on your canvas screen so that it's easier for you to see it, to, you know, size it, whatever it may be. So first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to click the down arrows just to show you all of the different pieces. Look at how many layers this is. It's crazy. Each of our popsicles are two layers, so we have a lot of ungrouping to do. Look at this, it's crazy. This is not the way that I would ever set up an SVG for someone to use, but a lot of times you'll find SVGs like this from people who don't use them in a capacity with Cricut, and sometimes this is the right way to do it for other programs. But in the Cricut, this is craziness. So the first thing that I have to do is I have to ungroup the first major group that it's in. And again, group is only to hold these together on our screen. So let me hit make real quick, just so you can see the insanity that this is going to be when you hit make. Look at hello. How does that make sense? Not only that, it's going to be cutting each of those letters individually. So what a pain. Now you're going to have a lot of pieces because you're going to have the different color popsicles, but your popsicle sticks are all together. It's just a little crazy. We just don't love this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be using the attach, the ungroup, and we're going to show you how to make this so that it works correctly. So the first thing, like I said, we need to do is we need to do a major ungroup, which is ungrouping the entire design. So if you click the ungroup button, you're still going to have a lot of groups to go through, but we have to do each one individually. So for this one, we first need to click ungroup again, but now you're going to notice you still have another whole group. So you want to make sure that you get rid of all of these down arrows when you're ungrouping your design. So you're going to have to hit ungroup a lot with this one because you need to get rid of every single one that has a down arrow. So I'm just clicking each down arrow section and choosing ungroup. So click the down arrow and choose ungroup. The one with the down arrow and choose ungroup. Now everything is its own individual piece and we can move them all around. So you can see, I'll click undo here in a second. But look at how crazy this is. Do you see this? Why is this like this? This makes no sense. So like I said, sometimes these, you're gonna get these really strange things that are gonna happen, and that's why it's important to know how to work with this. So I'm gonna go ahead and click undo until everything's back where it should be. I'm going to go ahead and get all those pieces. So now everything's back where I want it to be. Now the first thing that I want you to do is you'll notice that these items are all touching and overlapping. Now when you want to cut them out, you want to make sure that you don't have any like cut lines in between the letters. So this is where weld will come in. So you're getting a little bit of a bonus tip here. I want you to select the entire hello word. So you can just kind of make sure it's all selected. I just drew the square around it. Sometimes that's easier. Then you're going to go down to combine. Now you can use weld, which is permanent. So if you're never going to change this, you can just use weld and it's fine. But if for some reason you think maybe you'll want to change it someday, you can also use unite. Unite is going to hold everything together and it's going to create it so that there are no cut lines between your letters. Now, the next thing I want to do are these popsicle sticks. I'd really like them to stay in place. So you can do this. You can grab all these and we can go ahead and use attach. Now you'll notice that you have this little paper clip and all of your popsicle sticks are under that section. Now I can click make. Now it is going to tell me I need the longer mat again just because I've left this kind of big. And you're going to see that we have our hello and notice that now there's no cut lines between anything. And I'll actually go back and attach this so that you can see the cut lines. Then you've got your popsicle sticks or your popsicle and then your popsicle stick. So everything's held in place. Now again, it's on a bigger mat. But let's go ahead and we'll show you this hello real quick. I'm going to change the color on it so that you can see it a little bit better. And I'm gonna undo unite. So I'm gonna undo the unite. Now you'll see, do you see where you have all the cut lines? You can see the little lines between the letters and then this one right here that goes into the O. If I just simply attach those, all those cut lines stay in place. But if I combine them with unite, all the cut lines are gone except this little one, which there's really not much we can do about that. And it won't be noticeable, so I wouldn't worry about it. But that is where attach, unite, and apparently weld or, you know, group and all of that come into play. Now, for example, with these, if I, for some reason, just want to hold them all together so that I'm not moving them around on my mat, I can use group. It's not going to change their color, but it will hold them in place here on my canvas. So I maybe need to move them out of the way for some reason. I don't know why, but maybe I do. Now that everything's held together, you can move things, you can size things, whatever you need to do. But you can group the whole thing again, even after you've done the attaching on the separate portions. You can group them again, and now it's all one piece, so we can resize it down or up without having to worry about grabbing all of our parts. Or we can move it around our screen without accidentally grabbing something. So if I ungroup them really quick, let's say, oh, I want to move this over, it's in my way. Oh, I only grabbed the popsicles. Shoot, that's annoying. I can just simply group it again and move everything out of the way. That is where group and attach come in handy, and they are so important to know how to use and to know the difference. So just one more time, just so that you are fully aware and I've given you all of your knowledge, group is to hold items together on your canvas. It will not change their colors. It will not do any of that, but it will keep them in place for things like sizing, for moving them around your mat without moving something out of the way. And then attach is used with like colors only to hold things in place once you're ready to cut them. Now you'll notice that, again, I'll show you this since I've got stuff grouped. You'll see that I have the group for the cat and the group for our Hello Summer. Now, if I click make, what you're going to see is that you're going to have still separate mats. So I have a separate mat for my cat, a separate mat for one of the cuts for the popsicle tops. There's the popsicle bottoms. Now this is the same color, so it's gonna have the popsicle and the hello on it, but you can see each popsicle, even though they were grouped, have their own section, and then here is the wording for the cat. So that's just a little, you know, review in case you needed to know a little bit more about group and attach. I think it's really important to know how to use the functions correctly in Design Space. That way you know how to use them and you can help others by explaining the difference as well. I hope that you picked up some information and learned something new today. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Be sure you're subscribed here. That way you don't miss out on any of the crafty content we have coming. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting.